truly an honor to follow Bill Phyllis. I used to be on the other side here not so long ago, and it's been a long road for a lot of folks to get where we are today, and it's very humbling. An entire generation of Ohio's children have gone to schools that have been unconstitutionally funded. That must end. And that is why my subcommittee heard over 50 hours of testimony from more than 320 people on this plan the governor put forth. That's why we went out to Springfield Township, Marietta, and Dayton to hear from folks around the state about this plan, an unprecedented outreach from a standing General Assembly Committee on Education. That's why we've worked long and tirelessly, even through births of children. I thought I'd laugh at that. To ensure that Ohio's children, belonging to my four-year-old and now one-week-old generation, won't go through the same unconstitutionally funded system. Never again. The governor gave us a bold vision for a new day in education. And he gave us that vision in an almost unprecedented time of economic difficulty. We took that vision and ran with it, strengthening it where it needed girding and coming up with some ideas of our own that will further that vision of a new era. Fundamentally, what has changed in the way Ohio funds its schools with this plan is this. Instead of taking the money we have and trying to distribute it, we're going to determine what Ohio's children need to succeed, and then we're going to fund it. It's a revolutionary approach to education in this state, and a bold, refreshing look at education funding nationally.